Well, it's Friday night, morning before opener. I got my CV Optima Pro ready to go. I shot it a few times just to make sure it still works. It's still on. It works great. I can get 3 shots out of it before I gotta clean it again. So I hope I need 1 to kill a deer, not 3. So, but yeah, she's all good to go. I have a couple extra shots in there if I need them. So we'll see what happens tomorrow morning. We'll keep you guys posted. Well, opening morning went by. There's no deer. No deer that showed up. There's a lot of tracks now that we have snow. I can see tracks. So I went and set. Nothing came out. So now I gotta do some house chores and gonna plan on sitting out again tonight. So yeah, that's the plan. I don't have any more big bucks on my cameras for the last week or so. So I'm not sure if they got shot or they just moved out or what's going on. But we'll have to see. So for now we're just doing chores and getting ready for evening hunt. This is the first day, so we have a whole 2 weeks, 3 weekends to go. So all kinds of time. Alright, back to work. Just so you guys can see, those are my fish houses. That's where I usually hunt at the house. I have my trees standing, those trees. That's pretty much where they usually come out. But they're also on the north side of my property. Also have another grass hay field. Sometimes they come out that way, but not too often. Yeah. But the south side is pretty much the one that produced me deer before. Well, I guess every year since we moved here. But yeah, we'll get back to work. See what happens tonight. Tonight was another bust. I did see a doe and a fawn come out, but this muzzle loading season we do have to get a buck. And we don't have I don't have a doe tag for muzzle loading season. So it's gonna be a little more challenging, but I think I'm debating about going out to the power line tomorrow morning instead of sitting at the house. I think I'll sleep on it and see what happens. Well, at least I've seen some deer. And when there's does and fawns, eventually there's bucks too, so that's a good sign. It's only the first day, so a lot of time to go. So go back in, have some supper, and wake up in the morning and make a decision, see where I'm gonna go. So see you guys in the morning. Yeah, so this morning I decided to go and hunt on the power line. The winds are gonna be almost perfect to do that instead of staying at home. Yeah, so we're gonna do that instead. It's freaking foggy though, so I'm not sure how that affects hunting at all. But it doesn't really matter since it's muzzle loading season. Can't be shooting where the hell 300-400 yards down there anyway, so it should be okay as long as they're moving. So we'll give this a shot, then we're gonna go home and butcher some chickens. So either way, I'm gonna see blood today. Oh, look at that, it's kind of cleaning up. So yeah, that's the plan. See what happens.
Power line. This is definitely more deer hunting weather. There's a little bit of snow, a little bit of frost in the trees and the bushes. My mirror's even frosted up, so I can use it. But it's more like it. No Nothing is really moving though. I haven't heard any shots, but that could be because a lot of people muzzle load around here, so we'll keep sitting and hopefully something comes out. Well, didn't see anything, so we're gonna head home and get some butchering done, and then we'll think I'll sit at home tonight. I'm not gonna come back out here again till next weekend. Is the chicken murder zone. We chopped some heads off. We're gonna dunk them in hot water and pluck them. But there's a few of them left now. I just figured I'd film some of these gruesome stuff in case somebody wants to see.
Anyway, what I did, yeah. I took a picture of them.
The chickens.
Oh, it turned out so nice.
Dunk them in there. Pluck them over here. And then we all got it out and good to go. Well, hello guys. Didn't get any more hunting after the chicken butchering. We got company coming over, and by the time they left and we got stuff done, it was dark. So there went dead hunting. So the last few days I've been working. I had no time to hunt either. So now it's Friday, second weekend. Heading out to the cabin. We're gonna stay out there with the girls and see what we can do. Have some fun, do some hunting, spend some family time. It snowed, so it's kind of white out. It's not a lot of snow, but it's cold, so it's not gonna melt. So we'll see if the deer gonna start moving or they just gonna hide and move away. I don't know. I'm anxious to go see what kind of tracks we have and see if we can get something this weekend. This part of Minnesota, we have to apply for a doe tag. It's a lottery zone, so we can shoot a buck, but for a doe I'd have to have a doe license, which I don't have, so we have to be a little more picky about what we're gonna shoot if something comes out. So, but we'll give it a shot, have some fun, do some hunting. It's gonna stay below freezing all weekend long, so hopefully get the deer moving
As I'm looking around, looks like there's some snow clouds coming in too, so even tonight might be a good night to go out and hunt, but by the time I get things organized at the cabin, it's gonna be too late for that. But I'll go out there first thing in the morning and see what happens. So, that's the plan for the weekend, stay tuned. First things first, we gotta get the generator going. I think she's gassed up enough, it should be okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah. That's good to go. We gotta go to the cabin and get the heat going. Shut this. I think I shut the door. It's just so much more quieter. See, that's just enough snow. I'm not sure if I showed you guys inside the cabin. There. Lights are on. We're gonna turn on the heat. Let's see. There. Just the good old propane stove, furnace, whatever you want to call it, does the job. It's been shut off, well not shut off, it's on the night mode. It kept it about 58 in here. It's 23 outside, and yeah, doesn't take long, maybe an hour. We're gonna have it in the 70s in here. So it works pretty good. But yeah, this is our living room. Little TV. And then we have a bedroom here with just a couple bunk beds. Some more junk stuff. A gun rack. And a big boy's bed. Dream catcher, so you won't have nightmares about big bucks. Yeah, that's about it. Got the heat going. It's gonna be good. I have to start the water pump. Pump some water, fill up our water tank. This is our bathroom. So we have this tank here that we fill up with water. And then we pump with that pump into the back of the toilet. And then also on top here we have this tank we can fill up with the pump from the outside, and that kind of does the same job, fills up the tank. But if we I'll come out here for a weekend. That's not quite enough, so we have the second tank to be able to still flush the toilet. Then we do have a sink to wash our hands and a mirror to make sure we look good before we go out there for the doors. I'm just kidding. But anyway, so yeah, that's what it is. Alright, well, I'll go get some water going before the girls get out here, and then we'll think about supper. Okay, well, let's see if we can get water. And go. Ooh, it's getting it. Uh-huh. Sounds like water flowing. She's screwing up in here. Very good. Actually, threw it up pretty fast. All ready for the evening. The girls are on the way. They're gonna bring some hamburgers. We can fry it up for supper. We'll have hamburgers and chips. We have a couple cans of beans we can open up if they want to, and then just settle in, watch some TV, spend some good family time. Well, open up a can of beer. It's been a long work week, lots of stress, but it's time to de-stress, and I'm gonna open up the jar of some pickled eggs. My father-in-law makes these, and they're freaking awesome. Come on, there it is. All right. It's perfect. Not sure what he puts in there, but looks like a little hot peppers and eggs and some vinegar. I'm not sure what else is in there, but no, here we go. It's about 22 degrees outside, so it's definitely below freezing, but doesn't feel too bad. There's no wind at all, so there's no wind chill with it, so shouldn't be too bad. We'll go sit till about 9 o'clock and come back, have some breakfast, and go for a drive. I'd like to see the forest when it's nice and white. So we'll go and sit. Nice morning, but I didn't see no deer.
No shots fired. So we go back to the cabin and have ourselves some breakfast. And then regroup and come up with a plan for the rest of the day. But it's so nice and peaceful. I think I'll come back out here tonight again. Sunday afternoon. I did not hunt after Saturday morning. Actually, we went for a road hunt and that was about it. I got sick. I got the chills and shivers and all kinds of goofy stuff going on, so I could not go out and sit in the deer stand, that's for sure. So I missed out on Saturday night. I missed out on this morning. I'm just going home now, hauling some stuff home from the cabin. We're gonna shut it down for the season. Last weekend, I'm gonna just hunt at home. I'm still not feeling great at all, so I'm not sure what's going on. I got some kind of bug. But yeah, that kind of sucks. Because it's snowing outside now, so this morning and last evening would have been pretty much perfect for hunting. But I couldn't do it, so I hope I feel better. I'll try to go and sit at the house this evening, maybe. I have a Christmas party to go to, so maybe it won't happen, but we'll see. Kinda sucks, but it is what it is. Just got roll with the punches. See, I'll go home, haul this stuff home, and then we'll see, maybe go sit out there, I don't know. Let you know. On the week, on the work week done. So it's Friday afternoon, Friday evening. I'm on my way home from work now. It's only 1 degree, so we do have a temperature. I'm gonna try to sit out in my fish house. It'd be colder than heck, so, but I have heat in there. I'm thinking by the time I get the heat going and heat it up, it's gonna be almost time to quit, but at least it'll be set up for tomorrow morning. That's the plan. We shut the cabin down last week, and so now this week I'm just gonna sit at the house, the fish house, and see what happens there. There's not much for tracks, so it is what it is now. Might as well just finish her off and see what happens. Winds are out of north, and in my research it says that secondary rut should be happening this weekend, so we might get lucky. But we'll put in the work and go from there, so let you know what happens. Well, I came back to the garage. There's no deer moving tonight. It's 1 degree and it started to kind of snow, so I set up the heat. I put a battery in my fish house so we can have some heat. It's gonna be nice and warm tomorrow morning in there. I can get it cooking to 90 degrees if I wanted to, but that's the plan. Go out first thing in the morning, get the heat going, and just sit. So here we go, last day of muzzle loading season. I didn't film much the last couple of days, there's nothing really going on. It was too cold, it was full moon at night, so deer were moving at night, nothing during the day. I haven't seen
not even tracks around the house. So I'm coming out for a last drive out in the woods. As you can see, it's nice and pretty. It's really cold. Well, I started the day with 11 below. It's kind of warmed up now to about 10 above. No wind, so there's no wind chill, but it is still really cold. As I drive around here, I can see tracks in the woods, but yeah, I'll just go for a drive and see what I can see. I gotta go still take my deer stand off from the power line. I wanna get that done. And yeah, just cut down a little Christmas tree from the cabin for the girls so they have their live Christmas tree. And that would be the end of the season, so I don't know, still looking around. You just never know what you can find, so.
This season by Calvin Smith, an excellent fifth round pick in 2014, and for the Vikings, their first negative play today. That was a common thread this week for Mike Zimmer to eliminate negative plays. Tackles for loss, sacks, penalties, stuff like that.
Some of those are in the running back call again. Jerick McKinnon just trying to take it outside. You've got to cut the play up and run it where it's designed to go.
Second and 11 from the 21 pistol formation. Bradford in the short shot behind him. McKinnon. Yeah, that's the pass. Jags wearing their black uniforms trimmed in teal with the gold and black helmets, the Jaguar on each side. Blake Bortles in the first half, 11 of 16, 123 yards, sacked by Everson Griffin and Brian Robinson. Passer rated 91.4. The Jaguars had 50 rushing yards, 3.6 yards per carry. Jacksonville was 2 of 8 on third down. Minnesota was 0 of 5 on third down conversions in the first half. First and 10, Jacksonville game tied at 9 just to start the second half. Bortles under center, handoff TJ Yeldon, looking for a block from his right guard, and he got it, and then he's encountered immediately by Jack Greenway, Shamar Stephen, and Anthony Barr. Gain of 3 by TJ Yeldon, his second and 7.
And one of the things the Viking defense, Paul, is going to have to do is limit these first down rushing yards. As Everson Griffin comes out and Daniel Hunter comes in, you can't let...
That was a little tougher than I thought.
15-yard penalty.
Stand was kind of froze down, so it took me a while to get it moving, but we are on the way to the cabin. Dragging the stand behind us, so. Whew, that was a little workout. But this officially puts our season to the end once the deer stands are back at the cabin, so. I think it was time. It was a rough year with just hot temperatures during regular rifle season. We don't usually see that out here, and it just helps the deer not to move. I don't even know if they even got in full rut. This weekend should be secondary rut, but I still didn't see not much activity as far as deer go. Usually, between rifle and muzzle loading season, we can fill out our tags. This year, I got the one deer that opening rifle season morning, and it was just so bad, we had to take care of it right away. Well, take care of it, I mean, just skin it and quarter it up and put it in the freezer, just so it doesn't go bad. And haven't seen nothing since. So it's been just a challenging, different year for deer hunting, but I just wanted to document it so you guys can see the struggles. And I was hoping to get more deer on camera, but that of course didn't happen. So it is what it is. But it's all about fun. Myself, the wife, the kids, we all had fun. We stayed at the cabin and spent time as a family, and that's what it's all about. So there you have it. I'm gonna go sit this down at the cabin, close up all the windows so birds and mice and stuff don't get in it, and we go from there. Deer stand back at the cabin. Snow, rabbit tracks all over the place out here. But we're gonna shut it down and won't be back out here till springtime sometime. Unless we decide that we talked about refinishing the flooring. So if it's gonna be between finishing up ice fishing and nothing else to do until thaw out, you might come and spend a couple of weekends working on the flooring.